Hello and welcome to Switzer Investing Insights brought to you by NAB Trade. And this week we want to look at the outlook for November, but we always start by looking at the month before. Paul?
Yeah, Peter, look, a little bit negative in October. The markets just went into the red marginally. Still very healthy gains year to date. If I go to the components of the market, Peter, you can see the returns for the top 20 stocks, the mid-cap 50 stocks, which the stocks ranked 51st to 100, and the small ordinary stocks ranked 101 to 300. Look, again, nothing really to stand out there, but all parts of the market are up, but some of those parts are still lagging a little bit.
All right, Paul, let's look at the important changes in the industry sectors. There's some really interesting stuff there.
Yeah, there is here, and it's really it's a standout month for healthcare, Peter, up over 7%. And that's largely to do with CSL and ResMed. And if you haven't been long CSL, your portfolio is going to be underperforming in October. And chances are because healthcare is the best performing sector this year, and CSL is now the second biggest company by market cap, your portfolio is underperformed for the year. So this is really a CSL story. Industrial is also positive. Names like Transurban, Sydney Airport and Brambles led that up. The big sectors, financials, are down. Particularly at the end of the month on the back of the ANZ result, but also we saw materials, the BHP and Rio's also down. So look, all sectors in the green year to date, but a bit of a mixed performance during the month of
October. Yeah, and rate cuts aren't good for financials, Paul. And one thing I will say, if people haven't got CSL or ResMed in their portfolio, they haven't been listening to you and me for the last 2 years, I'd say. All right, let's go to the November and the international outlook.
Yeah, and I think this is really where the rubber hits the road, because what's been leading our market has been the direction from offshore, Peter. So just continue to look at the factors that could impact the market in November. The first thing is to acknowledge that the US market's at an all-time high. And it's done that despite all the noise about things like impeachment and the trade war and what will the Federal Reserve cut rates and all those type of things. So the fact, and we've had a reporting season which, you know, has been okay.
Yes. When it was expected to be quite negative, wasn't it?
Yeah, and look, it hasn't been brilliant, but it's been better than some very low expectations, and the market is sitting at an all-time high. So I think that's the first thing to acknowledge. The Federal Reserve's probably signalled that now rates are on hold. It hasn't ruled out a cut, but I think the markets have given up expectations of another cut in the next this side of Christmas and probably early into next year. So we're going to see a bit more. Yeah, it's now sort of data dependent, to use that phrase.
Yep.
Clearly, Europe is still been pretty depressed. It remains moribund. China, we've seen slowing growth rates there. So this is the whole, where equity markets is all about the US. And I guess in many things, it comes down to the US-China trade dispute, Peter, because despite all the other factors, you know, the US market's on high and the markets want this dispute solved, don't they?
Yeah, you're right, Paul. I think the fact that you've got a trade deal heading in the right direction should be inked, as President Trump said, in the not too distant future. You throw in the fact that the Federal Reserve has been cutting interest rates, and you're right, the earnings season was better than expected. Put all that together, that's not a bad result considering all the negatives that have been hanging over the market.
The other interesting thing, Peter, of course, is just in timing. I mean, we've sort of gone through the crazy months of
September, October,
and we're now into November. So we might come back to that. Let's just move on to, let's look at anything happening here in Australia. I mean, the Reserve Bank has cut three times. It's now appears to be on hold. Again, it's a lot more pressure for government stimulus as opposed to any further cuts in interest rates. We're sort of halfway through the AGM season, so that'll sort of pan out for the rest of November. And look, the issue with AGMs is not that there's physically a meeting, but of course it's a chance when companies update the market about how they're trading. So you can get both good and bad messages out of AGMs, so something to watch out for. And we've got the completion of sort of the major bank profit reporting season. I think the other factor, Peter, is we still have very cashed up investors, and they've had so much cash thrown in this year through dividends and all the other things. And look, our market just doesn't seem to want to go down despite how many of us might think it looks overvalued a bit.
Yeah, I think in many ways our market looks like it's a greyhound in the box, just waiting for that box lid to come out so they can fly out of the boxes. And I think the trade deal would be the most important thing for that.
And as we come into Christmas, Peter, sort of a Santa Claus rally. I mentioned before we're sort of through the scary months of September and October.
Yeah, I think the Trump team will be working on trade deal phase two across Christmas. And if they get some really big news, and I think they'll want it, they want to get most of this trade stuff out of the way so they can concentrate on the election campaign. And they'd love to think that the market's still going up and that the outlook for the economy is improving because they have had made some progress on trade.
And as you've said, President Trump is the most sort of market-focused president we've seen. He tweets when the US market hits all-time highs, and got tries to take a bit of credit for that.
And the market likes that.
And the market likes that. Yeah. So I think our direction of our market, we're still in the hands of the US, and at the moment the US looks like it wants to take the market higher.
Yeah, and I also think that the Aussie economy is slightly improving, and that's why the Reserve Bank is holding back on interest rates at the moment. If things don't improve, they will cut again. That's our wrap-up for November. Thanks for joining us on Switzer Investing Insights, brought to you by NAB Trade.